everybody. Welcome back to the GSL Code A quarterfinals. I am Doa. With me is Moltrap.
That's me.
Just saw our last Protoss in Code A eliminated from the tournament, unfortunately. But hey, you know, if you're a Terran fan, that's not so bad, right? Right? And if you're a Slayers fan, that's not so bad. If you're a Teja fan, that's not so bad.
Definitely.
Always look on the bright side of life, Moltrap. So, up next, you know who's playing next?
I do know who's playing next. Would you like me to tell you?
I already know. I've got a big smile on my face. It's the type of smile that only FXO Leenok can produce.
It's the type of smile that only a fanboy can have.
That's so true. I'm not going to apologize. I can't help it. I love watching this guy play. We'll see how he does. He's up against a really strong opponent, though. He's up against I'm Yoda, mm-hmm. who's a really, really strong Terran player. I think Leenok's got his work cut out for him. It's going to be a pretty close match. Yoda, historically, in the games I've seen him play, if I remember right, he seems to be a pretty good TVZ-er. So either one of these guys could take this. That's the cool thing about the matches today, Moltrap, is that I feel like each one could go either way. And then we see 2-0s for the first two matches.
I didn't think either one of them was going to go either way, actually. I was pretty... No.
Well, aren't you just so smart, Moltrap?
What can I say? I don't know. A lot of people think that Czech still has a lot going for him. I see him as a little bit washed up, so that's kind of why I was predicting that pretty hard. JYP, like I said, hasn't impressed me yet. I'm still going to give him a chance, but...
You've been right twice today already.
I've been right twice today. I'm going to go with you on this one, though. I think Leenok has been playing spectacularly this season. He has been not just playing like a good Code A player. He has been showing Code S style play
on top
of everything. Like you always say, he has great decisions. He's been playing really good. Yoda, he's... he was not expected to beat Tassadar last week, though, and he did. He beat the best, who is a... pretty good Terran player.
Yeah.
I'm not a fan of him personally, but a lot of people tell me that he's really good, but he gets nervous, so sometimes he doesn't do as well as he can.
Mm-hmm. That's true. Well, he did just get, a 3-kill in the team league.
Just got a 3-kill to save FXO in the team league the other day. So, very strong Terran player there as well. So, Yoda, killing some nerds here to get to this point is definitely not just a pushover win for Leenok. He's going to have to fight his best. He's going to have to fight his hardest. And, Yoda, he's lost to Leenok last season, actually.
Code A season 4,
Leenok knocked him out of the Code A after he beat Min. So, a little bit of a revenge match for Yoda here, but precedent has clearly been set. There is the man himself from the Team Incredible Miracle, Yoda.
That's right.
They put Terran because they don't actually know what race Yoda is.
Looking pretty good for over 900 years old, I gotta say.
Dagobarian, maybe.
Dagobarian? Is that the people who live on Dagobah?
Well, he lived on Dagobah.
Now,
would you call it a Dagobin?
I don't know.
Is he Dagobish?
I don't know. Dagobish? Could go either way. He has not played a Zerg yet in this tournament, actually, whereas Leenok has beaten both Boxer and another Terran. That name escapes me right now, actually. But
I can look it up real quick.
Maka, I want to say. Yeah. Yeah, I believe you beat Maka.
Here's something for you guys as well, by the way, if you're talking about stats. I mentioned this when he played last game as well, last series, last week. Leenok is 9-1 his last 10 games against Terran. He's like 22-2.
Yeah, Leenok
in the last couple months against Terran. He beat Hack in the GSTL. He beat Maka. He beat Boxer.
He's 2-0. 2-0 Boxer. Yeah, 2-0 Maka Prime.
Yep.
He's been in Code S. He's been around the GSL for quite a long time. This guy is great. Now, I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to pretend like he can do no wrong, because he has had some games where he's made terrible decisions.
Yeah.
He was in a bit of a slump for a while. When I saw him come back into Code A again this season, I'm like, all right, is he going to be the Leenok from last season that didn't play that well, or is he going to be different? But this season, he is playing better than I've ever seen him play before. I really feel like he could win it all, but, can he keep up the momentum? That's the thing, is that you see players play really well in certain rounds, and then they get to a certain point, and it just kind of, dies off. So he's got to continue to prove himself today.
Yeah.
And he's got to do it against one of the strongest Terrans in Code A, too.
That's right. Now, the first map is going to be Belshear Beach.
Yep.
And it's going to be followed by Terminus Re. And again, If we see a game three, we're going to see it on Daybreak, but we didn't get to see that last.
We might.
Last time. Yeah. There's the limited maps. Crossfire limited by Yoda. And Leenok does not want to play on Zelnaga Fortress. Very common Zerg versus Terran elimination.
Oh, yeah. Definitely. There's actually a lot of people in the studio today for these matches, too. I mean, people get really excited for Code A these days, and they should. It's a great tournament. We've got a lot of former Code S players in here. We're going to get right into the game here. Leenok versus
Yoda.
And here he is on the right side of GSL Belshire Beach in the red color. Our Terran player from the team Incredible Miracle. Can he do or do not?
I am Yoda!
I know. He's going to try.
There is no try.
You're right. It's either do or do not. That's right. There's no gray area in StarCraft 2. Over on the left side of the map. The map is...
FXO Lina!
Well, that failed hard, didn't it?
You know what would be awesome?
What?
It would be awesome if Yoda made a Viking, right? Huh? And it got killed in the middle of the map, and the Viking, the pieces of it fell into the water, and Yoda just, like, reached out with his mind and lifted the Viking out of the water.
The SCV is like, it's too big.
He's like, no, size doesn't matter.
That's right.
Lifts it out of there and then repairs it.
Oh, man. That was a good start. That's the best Star Wars joke you've ever made, Mulder.
Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
Right. You're learning.
He's at the IM house. He's like making MVP run around in the forest, and he's like hanging onto his back.
He's got like Nesty with a backpack on. You know, he's parkouring through the streets of Seoul with I'm Yoda in his backpack.
Exactly.
I can see it happening.
Oh boy.
Kind of curious to see how Yoda's going to open. He decided to not wall off immediately. Which isn't really a terrible, terrible thing, because most Zergs are going to go hatch first, so it's not, you know, like a huge risk or anything. But, you know, I'm curious to see what he's going to use to make that wall. If it's going to be just another supply depot and a factory, or if he's going to put, like, a bunker there, or maybe just supply depots, too. I mean, there's a lot of options. There is a tech lab going down on the barracks, so we may just see a Reaper expand here. Ta-da. And that Overlord is going to jump into the bushes.
Gonna be able to hide up there.
Well, this time there's no barracks nearby to lift up and snipe it either, like a lot of players have been doing. Jakji almost knocked over the set on me. Just
Jakji almost knocked it over on you. Oh, Jakji, he's gonna Reaper expand here, and interestingly, he's actually getting a second refinery right now to follow up this Reaper. So we might see him go from this Reaper into not an expansion like we often see, but maybe into Banshees or something.
Well, he's getting two gas right now. Could go for Blue Flame, could go for Banshees as well. I think either is a completely valid opening. Oh, it looks like he is going to switch it over and go for Blue Flame, though. He's got the factory that's ready to... not ready. It's going to be moving on to the tech lab, I believe, because he did lift off that barracks.
True.
Might be flying. What is he doing?
Well, he's actually making a second tech lab at his other barracks. Maybe he's going to do a starport on one tech lab and switch the factory to the other and do both.
I think it's going to be two-port Banshee Moltrap.
That actually could be...
We see it every once in a while. It tends to catch a lot of Zergs off guard these days.
Reaper
not the Scantipede. Why? Reaper. Reapers are like... convicted psychopaths or something. So no wonder they would be jerks and kill Scantipedes. Maybe he thought it was a Zerg. They do look kind of Zergy.
They do look Zergy. Man, dude, if you're out by yourself, just you and your jetpack and your gauss pistol,
right?
You're in the middle of nowhere, you see anything move, you're going to shoot that, man. You don't want to take any chances with the Scantipede. And we are seeing Nitro Paxis actually making Reaper speed along with the Blue Flame Hellion upgrade.
Well,
what is going on, Doa? My mind is on fire.
That is actually extremely interesting. Now he's going to need to make sure he doesn't lose any of these Reapers.
He is actually
making... This is something completely new, or at least something we haven't seen in quite a while. I certainly haven't seen it before in that I can recall. He's making two Reapers at once right now. Reapers and Blue Flame Hellions are going to be so, so good against everything that Leenok gets, except for Roaches, which he's not getting right now. In fact, he's using a lot of drones.
Zergs these days are often just going a couple spines and using their queens Actually, a Roachhorn just went down.
Yeah, there's a Roachhorn. I mean, Leenock has been kind of poking in and looking at the natural. He hasn't seen a second base yet, so you can kind of expect there's going to be something coming that he's going to want to have roaches for. You can see that he does have couple queens out already for the Banshee contingency, but
I'm like literally holding my breath right now, waiting to see what happens. Oh,
he sees the Blue Flame of Hellions.
He shows
so
them.
Weird. It's not that weird, so still doesn't really realize what's going on. And look at that, all the Reapers being hidden.
Yeah.
Oh, Moltrap, this is going to be so cool.
Blue Flame and Nitro Packs finished at the same time, and he's got his setup here at the front. He's got Spinecrawlers.
Oh, man.
Is he going to make roaches, though?
Look at that, the Reapers are as fast as the Hellions. I love this.
Oh,
so
man,
cool.
There they go, and they're going to own those queens badly.
They're going to do so much damage.
Nice transfuse.
Trying to keep the queens alive, but it's not going to work. Leenock producing Lings, he's producing some roaches now.
Look how fast the Spinecrawler goes down to the concentrated fire of those Reapers. That was ridiculous.
Wow, okay, so three more Reapers in production right now, more Hellions as well. And those roaches, I mean, they can be outranged by the Reapers, they can be outranged by the Hellions if you micro very, very carefully. It's going to be tough, not a lot of roaches out yet. How fast can he kill the roaches? Not the ideal composition to go against this.
No, he's going to lose the Hellions. The Reaper's still staying alive.
Yeah, really nice Sim City from Leenock right now.
Staying
very safe. He's handling this brilliantly so far.
I really feel like Yoda should be making better use of the mobility of his Reapers because there's nothing in Leenock's main base to block these. And if he goes into the main and forces the roaches
back there,
he can run Hellions in the front, stuff like that.
True.
But he's not doing that. He's just keeping all of his forces together.
Well, he's got enough Reapers. He could potentially just kill off the Evo Chamber as well.
That's true.
Yep.
And he's actually just focus firing down these roaches, losing a lot, but also keeping.
That's just a bad idea. Yeah, it's not efficient enough at all. I mean, I like your idea of running the Reapers into the main base. That'd be much better at this point in time.
And here's the thing, Leenock has 52 harvesters. He has literally double the harvesters that Yoda does to 26.
Doesn't surprise me.
So, Yoda had a plan for this to just work and win.
Yeah.
And he's not really transitioning out of it very well.
Well, you know, it is an all-in. I mean, he is making that command center to try to take the gold and get back in this game. But here's the thing is, Yoda did a very unique opening, and that's good, that's cool. But the problem with that is sometimes you run into something with your cool, unique opening that never seen before, and you realize, I've never actually been in this position before either now.
Yeah.
I don't know how to react to this. And so now he's got to try to wing it at this point.
It was kind of a guess, too. I mean, oftentimes you see Zerg players, there we go, running in the main.
Yeah.
Is he going to do anything with this, though?
He's going to kill some drones. But, you know, Yoda's
because they're going to catch him. Oh, and pinches him against the roaches.
Yep, Leenock was ready with those roaches. You know, Yoda had taken long enough that Leenock had time. There it is, GG. Yeah, that's why they called an all-in, man, because you're all-in.
And
Leenock, look at that. This guy playing so magnificently. It brings a tear to my eye, Moltrap. There is nothing that this guy's run into this season that he has not reacted perfectly to. Such a strong Zerg right now.
Yeah, man. And that's the thing is Zergs will often, if they see Hellions, they'll often be like, all right, well, you know what? I'll just get spines and some speedlings to maneuver and box them into the spines and that kind of thing.
Yeah.
And I'll continue to drone up. And if he'd done that, then that strategy would have owned. It would have owned. But instead, he went for roaches to deal with the Hellions. And because he had that roach worn up and a few roaches on the way, the attack didn't really do much. So it was kind of a gamble. It was literally just like a 50-50 gamble. He's like, all right, well, if he gets roaches, I lose. If he doesn't get roaches, I win.
Well, it's a really good. I mean, it was a very deceptive opening, too. I mean, there's no way that Leenock would have really expected to see something like that. So, yeah, he just responded brilliantly. And that was also a really cool all-in from Yoda, too. I mean, that was actually really cool. I'm going to go back and watch that game a couple times later and check that out in a little bit more detail, I'm sure. So a really cool opening from Yoda. Didn't quite work out for him.
Pretty sweet, though, to see Nitro Packs being used.
Yeah, it's been a while since we've seen that. And it seems like we're in a period of innovation and growth in StarCraft II in Korea right now. We've been seeing a lot of things this season in both the Team League and Code S. And in Code A that we haven't really seen much before lately. We've been seeing a Hunter Seeker missile being made finally.
Yeah.
We've been seeing a lot of cool stuff. And I love these phases in StarCraft II. I mean,
the game is always evolving.
Yeah, it's neat when a matchup starts to evolve like that. Definitely. So our next map is going to be Terminus. A very large map. Could be good for either player in certain situations. I think it's one of the best maps we have at the GSL.
I like Terminus a lot. We always see really good games on it.
Absolutely.
And so we're going to find out here pretty soon if Yoda can come back and maybe tie it up. What's that?
I said the screen is loading. I'm excited.
I'm excited as well, man.
Yes.
All right, we're going to see if Leenok can bring it home 2-0.